The battlefield is a place of chaos and destruction. But few sights are as terrifying as the arrival of a tank. To the infantry caught in their path, a tank is an unstoppable force, an embodiment of sheer battlefield supremacy. Yet, even these steel giants, with all their armor and might, have a nemesis. A weapon designed to pierce their defenses, to exploit their vulnerabilities, and to turn the hunter into the hunted. The anti-tank missile, swift, precise, and utterly devastating, can reduce even the most formidable tanks to smoldering wreckage in seconds. From guided rockets to fire-and-forget systems, these weapons have redefined modern warfare, proving that no armored beast is truly invincible. Let's take a closer look at some of the most feared tank killers on the battlefield. Historically, the evolution of rocket-propelled infantry weapons was geared primarily towards developing specialized anti-tank weaponry. Nevertheless, past wars and skirmishes worldwide have underscored the increasing necessity for anti-structure potential. This realization led to an international trend among military forces and arms manufacturers towards creating a versatile rocket launcher capable of targeting personnel and structures alike. The RGW-90, also known as the Matador, is a unique, state-of-the-art rocket launcher collaboratively designed by Germany, Israel, and Singapore to address a multitude of battlefield threats. The RGW in the weapon's designation represents recoilless grenade weapon. The acronym Matador stands for Man-Portable Anti-Tank Anti-Door, aptly describing its dual-purpose design and showcasing its versatile operational capabilities. This weapon is affectionately known as the Nutcracker within the Israeli Defense Force, or IDF, which first used it in combat during Operation Cast Lead in 2009. The Matador distinguishes itself by its lightweight design. Its warhead is notably effective against both armored vehicles and robust structures like brick walls. The launcher measures about 3.3 feet long and weighs around 24.9 pounds when equipped with a laser rangefinder and reflex sight. It can effectively hit targets up to 0.31 miles away. The launcher tube, composed of reinforced fiberglass with polymer fixtures and styrofoam shock absorbers, houses minor steel components like screws and pins and some glass elements in the sights. The weapon is equipped with a telescopic sight mounted on a Picatinny rail. Night vision sights are also an option. A key attribute of the Matador is its wind-resistant projectile, resulting from its advanced propulsion system. This feature enhances the weapon's accuracy significantly. Operating the Matador entails choosing the desired warhead effect, extending the pistol grip, foregrip, and shoulder rest, and raising the sight. After aiming and setting the safety to fire, the weapon discharges upon pulling the trigger. The Matador can be safely operated in extreme temperatures, from minus 40 degrees Fahrenheit to plus 145.4 degrees Fahrenheit. One of the Matador's unique features is its minimal back blast, which ensures safe operation even in tight quarters. The Matador employs a counter-mass system to balance the weapon's recoil upon firing. This counter-mass comprises shredded plastic propelled from the weapon's rear when fired, which quickly slows due to air resistance, thus enabling safe firing in enclosed spaces. The Matador can be safely fired in confined spaces as small as 161.5 cubic feet, although hearing protection is recommended. The Matador's unique warhead boasts a selectable shaped charge capability. When the probe is extended, the warhead launches the charge liner into the target as a penetrator, capable of breaching thick vehicle armor. With the probe retracted, the warhead mimics a high explosive squash head round's behavior, spreading out on impact and then detonating. This causes significant damage to solid masonry, concrete, or stone walls, creating an opening at least 18 inches wide. Against thinner walls, like those of single-layer brick, the effect generates a large enough breach for a man to traverse. The operator can simply switch between these two settings by extending or retracting the probe. Matador's warhead can penetrate through 19.7 inches of equivalent rolled homogeneous armor. However, the lack of a precursor charge means that it performs poorly against reactive armor. The TOW missile is an anti-tank weapon that has become a mainstay of modern military arsenals. This weapon system was developed by the US Army during the Cold War and has since undergone numerous upgrades and improvements. It's one of the most common second-generation anti-tank missile systems in the world and is in service in more than 40 countries. The TOW missile, as the name suggests, is tube-launched and optically tracked. It is a wire-guided missile that is manually steered towards its target by the operator. The missile is fired after the weapons operator views a spot on the target with a telescopic sight. A two-stage solid propellant rocket motor powers the missile. The operator continues to follow the target by sight. The missile's control system is linked to the guidance computer via two wires spooling out from the back of the missile. On the missile, a high-intensity thermal beacon provides long-wave infrared tracking, while a xenon beacon provides short-wave tracking. This dual tracking technology outperforms infrared and electro-optical countermeasures. In the modern version, the ATGM has a sighting kit that combines a thermal sight and a laser rangefinder. One of the key advantages of the TOW missile is its versatility. It can be installed on military vehicles as a single tube pedestal mount, or as two tube or four tube under armor systems on vehicles such as the improved TOW vehicle, the Bradley fighting vehicle, the high mobility multi-purpose wheeled vehicle, and the AH-1 Cobra helicopter. TOW anti-tank missiles are more lethal than Javelins, Stugners, or Enlaw anti-tank missiles, as they can penetrate up to 35 inches of RHA, or rolled homogeneous armor. The extended range version of the missile, the TOW 2B Aero, is equipped with a blast fragmentation warhead that can cause significant damage to the surrounding area. The missile's warhead can also be customized to suit different battlefield scenarios, with options including armor-piercing and anti-personnel warheads. TOW 2B Aero is also equipped with a top attack capability, which allows the missile to hit the roof of a tank where the armor is often weaker. The missile is also capable of engaging helicopters and other aerial targets, making it a versatile weapon system that can be used in a variety of combat situations. Another development of the TOW 2B Aero, the wireless TOW 2B RF, is in production. TOW 2B RF is modified with a one-way stealthy radio frequency command link, which dispenses with the wirelink and gives a range of 2.8 miles. The system is compatible with current launchers. The long-range advantage of this system gives soldiers the ability to engage enemy armor from a safe distance, reducing the risk of casualties and allowing for more effective use of firepower. The TOW Buster Bunker is designed to destroy urban structures, earthen bunkers, field fortifications, and light-skinned armor threats. The TOW BB contains an impact sensor in the main charge, which optimizes warhead effectiveness. At range, the TOW BB can defeat double-reinforced concrete walls. Recent US Army qualification tests confirmed updates and improvements to the system's top-down attack capabilities, as well as the operational effectiveness of TOW. Furthermore, the system upgrades have extended the missile's life cycle past 2050. Raytheon Missiles and Defense has supplied over 700,000 TOW weapon systems to the US and Allied forces. During the Cold War, the US military faced the daunting prospect of overwhelming Soviet tank formations. Existing anti-tank weapons like the M-47 Dragon had limitations. They were wire-guided, requiring the operator to maintain a line of sight and manually guide the missile, making them vulnerable to countermeasures and return fire. A new generation of anti-tank weapons was needed, one that offered greater range, improved accuracy, and a fire-and-forget capability that allowed the operator to seek cover immediately after launch. The solution was the FGM-148 Javelin. The Javelin has the distinction of being a any known armor or AKA weapon. This means that it can defeat any known armor. This system, when loaded with a missile, weighs in at 50 pounds. Most of the weight comes from the missile. Despite this figure, it is still light enough for a single soldier to move around the battlefield, enabling guerrilla warfare tactics to be used against an invading army. This weapon is a fire-and-forget missile capable of guiding itself to the most valuable region of a tank from miles away. The weapon's sight uses DRS Technology's second-generation thermal imaging technology, based on the standard advanced DUAR assembly. The gunner's controls for the missile system are on the Javelin's Command Launch Unit, CLU, which has a sophisticated infrared sensor with multiple viewing modes. The day sight is equipped with factor 4 magnification, and the night sight with factor 4 and factor 9 magnification optics. Infrared sight works in both day and night, allowing soldiers to spot enemy tanks from a distance, even in low visibility situations. The fact the tube is detachable makes the CLU by itself an incredibly useful piece of equipment. With a carry weight of 6.4 kilos, the CLU incorporates a passive target acquisition and fire control unit with integrated day sight and thermal imaging capabilities. The user can select a firing mode with two options, direct and top, which change the trajectories depending on the object being targeted or the surrounding area. The top trajectory is ideal, as it targets the least protected section of a tank. But top may not always be possible, the target could be under an overpass or some other obstacle. The directional pad allows the user to adjust gates manually around the perimeter of the target's profile. So, what do you think about these weapon systems? What other pieces of military hardware would you like us to cover in our future episodes? Also, if you were lucky enough to see one of these weapon systems up close, or better yet, used one, please comment. Remember to hit the subscribe button and ring that bell to stay updated with our latest content. And while you're here, why not check out another one of our exciting videos? Thanks for watching, and see you in the next one.